This week, I wanted to have a look at how to create a third-person camera controller. This covers character movement and camera movement around that character. Let's not waste time describing this though and get right into the tutorial. First thing you'll want to do is create a new project and set up our scene. We need the ground and the player character, and of course we already have our camera. Use a cube to make the ground and scale this up. Then create a capsule for the player, making sure it's centered and scaled correctly. You can add materials to both the ground and the player if you like. Right click in the assets folder and create a material. You can then select whatever color you like for those. This next part, you will want to right click on the player and add a rigid body. Then set the constraints to freeze the X and Z rotations. Next up, create another cube and resize it. This will be used to indicate what direction the player is facing. Attach it as a child component to the player and edit its transform so it pokes out the front of the player. The next part is very important too. This will be used to control our camera and rotate around the player. So, right click and create an empty game object. Attach it to the player and reset the transform. Then alter the transform to match that shown here. Finally, attach the camera to the target as a child, alter the transform to and match that which is shown on screen. Now we have the scene set up and can create some code to control the game. So create two scripts, one called third person camera controller and the other called third person character controller. Attach the camera controller to the camera and the character controller to the player. And then we can write some scripts. Starting off, open the character controller to edit. The first line is a public float speed, which will represent how fast the player moves. We also need to add a method called player movement that we will call inside update. Write this by adding void player movement and your brackets as seen here. Then we need our movement input for horizontal and vertical. We get these using input.getAxis and look for horizontal and vertical, then assign the values to floating point numbers. We then create a vector 3 called player movement, and this is equal to new vector 3 hor, 0f, ver, and we multiply this by speed and time.deltaTime. We use time.deltaTime so that we can ensure the character moves smoothly and at the same pace across various hardware, and it's independent of frame rate. Then we actually move the player by adding transform.translate, player movement, space.self. Make sure to save the script and go back to Unity to try this out. Before playing though, make sure you add a value for the speed that you want to move at, so try some things out and see what feels right for your character. Next up, we need to write the script for the camera controller, so go ahead and open this up in the editor. Tidy up the script a bit and add in our initial variables. These are the rotation speed, which I am setting to 1, but you can mess around with this to see what works for you. Then we create our two public transforms for target and player, and of course our floats for mouse X and mouse Y. We need to create a method that will control and move the camera called cam control, and we want this to be called inside late update. So similar to the movement script we did previously, we want to get our user input first and assign it to float values. So add mouse X plus equals input.getAxis mouse X multiplied by rotation speed, and then mouse Y minus equals input.getAxis mouse Y times rotation speed. And mouse Y will control the camera moving up and down, so we want to make this negative, but some people might prefer it to be flipped. We also want to clamp the mouse on the Y rotation, and we do this with mouse Y equals mathf.clamp bracket mouse Y comma minus 35 comma 60 close brackets, and this prevents the camera from flipping around so it doesn't get too high and go fully around the player. Next, add transform.lookAtTarget to keep the camera focused on the right area. Then to control the rotation, add target.rotation equals quaternion.euler mouse y mouse x 0 and player.rotation equals quaternion.euler 0 mouse x 0. And this allows the camera to rotate, but also for the player to rotate too. So back in the start method, you can also add cursor.visible equals false and cursor.lockState equals cursor.lockMode.locked. And this removes the cursor and locks it to the center of the screen so it won't be in the way when you're playing. And then save everything and go back to Unity. Click on the camera in the hierarchy and there will now be two slots available in the inspector for our script. And this is for the target and the player. So drag both our target and our player into these relevant positions. You can also change the rotation speed here. Once that is complete, try playing the game and see how it works. You may see more clearly what is happening if you look at it from the scene view while you're playing. Now that is essentially how you would create a very basic third person character and camera controller. You can even add in a little bonus feature by doing the following to the cam control method. So if you go back to the camera controller script and add in the following. If input.getKey, keycode.leftShift, then we only want to rotate the camera, else we rotate both the camera and player, like we can see here. So save the script and go back to Unity, and if you try this out, you can now rotate the camera by itself if you hold down the left shift key. You can move through the level and rotate the camera around the player while doing this. Another issue that you may have with this camera is whenever you have a wall or object in your game. So if you look at this wall, when you move back against it, the camera goes through the wall and you can no longer see the player. So in the next video, I will show you how to hide the wall so that the camera can see through to the player like it is shown here. And with that said, we have finished another tutorial, but make sure to subscribe for more videos coming soon, and I'll see you in the next one.